Hey y'all, welcome back to Large Family Diabetic Cooking. I figured out what the issue was. The dough needed to be cold. And you need to spray your hands with some Pam, and that helps get it to go around the meat. So, I'm going to show you what I'm doing.
Are you recording again?
Can you please leave the room? I am recording, yes. Go ahead. Thank you. Go ahead. So I'm going to put some dough around the meat. And I'm going to show you what all needs to be done. But your hands do have to be well greased. And then you take your meat and you push it up and around. And there we go. I got the first tray done. We're going to do the next tray now. My hands do have to be well oiled. And then you're going to flatten it out like a pancake. And then it's going to get wrapped around your meat. All the way around. Okay. And then these will go in the oven on 350. And these would bake about the same time you would bake your, if you were making meatloaf. And about half an hour. Going to push this up and around your meat. There we go. Let me get some of this off and then spray my hands again. I had to refrigerate the dough for at least 20 minutes. So this is going to be part two. And I have some cream of mushroom soup in the microwave that we made that I'm going to my daughter wants to go over this. When this is done, you're going to sprinkle some cheese over top of it. Whatever cheese you want to use will work just fine. All right, I need to wash my hands because this dough is sticking, and then we'll finish the last two and get them in the oven. 350, half an hour. All right, he's being stubborn today. All right, let me spray my hands and then do this. for the last two. My hands and then wash this. We'll get these in the oven. Get my cream of mushroom soup. Going. And then we're going to shred up some I have some cheddar cheese here that is going to, when this is done, after half an hour, you will sprinkle your cheese over top. Let me wash my hands and then I'll come get these in the oven. That towel because I was touching raw meat. All right, let's get these in the oven. Ooh, okay, these are heavy. These are fine. It's not one handed. We're gonna cook, and then let me clean this off.
And then she has a small load for me to do real quick because she starts her job. So she needs me to wash her working hands.
Oh, okay. Let me put this away, and then we're going to wash up our bowl. Our food's in the oven. While that's cooking, let me put the macaroni and cheese in. My daughter made her famous macaroni and cheese last night.
So,
we're going to put it in the oven and heat it up. You had some last night?
Well, I had to make sure it wasn't poison.
Really?
Yeah. Make sure it was safe to eat it.
Put that down. Put it down. No. No. You heard Grandma. Grandma said no, and I meant it.
No.
Yes, no.
No.
Yes, no.
No.
Right. That's a good girl. Hey. Meme. You gonna do it? Go no, 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 no. No, 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 no. Gonna do it? Wanna show everybody you know how to do it? Come here. Say hi, everybody.
Say hi.
Say no, 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 no.
No.
Yeah, no, 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 no. You're going to be stubborn and not do it.
Yeah, those
no, 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 no. There she goes. No, 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 no. Mommy puts the clothes in the dryer.
You gonna help me?
Okay. Mommy's gonna give you stuff and you're gonna put it in the dryer. Push them in there. Good girl.
a big girl. Go ahead, push them in there. She's trying, but I think they're a little too heavy because they're wet. Give her one piece at a time. You can put some in, but give her one piece at a time. Put it in there, Mammy. Good girl. You're doing a good job, Mama. Like I said, that's going to take a half hour, and then we're going to sprinkle some cheese on it, which I'm going to cut up here in a second. Ooh, sorry, Mama. Can you hand me the cheese out of the refrigerator? I need the cheddar cheese.
What kind?
A little small steak knife. There you go. Thank you. All right. Now, we're going to cut up our cheese with our new gadget from QVC. This thing is really cool. I really like how it cuts the cheese. So, and when it's done, we'll sprinkle some cheese over top. Oh, good Lord. Mm. All right. That's all the cheese I need right now. I don't need any more because it's going to get sprinkled over all 12. We got macaroni and cheese in the oven. Worst thing for cheese. Okay. Cheese is ready. Okay. We're going to take this and suction it from the thing, and we're going to clean this so I can get it put up so the kids don't get hold of it. worthy. On 10 minutes. Our stuff's in the oven cooking. And let's clean this up. Water so hot it's melting the cheese. Got it all, and if there's nothing left on here, right. Now we're going to dry this up and get it put away. Because it's extremely sharp and I don't want to leave anything out for little minds to be tempted. That's like sitting a piece of candy on a piece on the table and telling them they can't have it. They're gonna find some way to get it. You might say no, but their whole body's like, yes, I can. This back in. Put that through. Put that in place. And then just screw this back on. And then dry this. And then put it back and suction it to my shelf. Shelf, and then I'll come back and get that knife.
One thing that cream of mushroom soup smells amazing.
We're going to check on our cream of mushroom soup, and if it's not done, it'll go back in for another 5 minutes because I put it on 10 minutes. Sorry about the part two, but I was getting a little frustrated, but I'm glad that I stuck it out and that I just didn't chuck it. I put it in the freezer to let it cool a little more, which made it easier, and then spraying my hands with some type of oil with the Pam helped a lot with being able to flatten it out and get it around the potato. When I sauteed the onions, she used ghee. I didn't have any ghee, so I just used butter. But ghee is made from butter. Anyway, so I figured well, I'm pretty sure there's a big difference. I've never tried ghee. Some people say they like it, some people say they don't like it. So I do want to try it, though. That is one thing I do want to try is ghee. But like I was telling you, earlier, and I lost my train of thought. I was making mayonnaise because I made some potato salad this past weekend. And because my grandson wanted ribs, so we had ribs, corn on the cob, potato salad, and I made my strawberry pretzel salad.
and I wanted to make homemade mayonnaise because I didn't think we had enough. Well, I used the extra virgin olive oil, smooth sautéing and stir frying, and it changed the taste of the mayonnaise. It tasted like soap. Like I put Dawn dishwashing liquid soap in it, and I was like, ew, that is just, that's nasty. So someone said to use linseed oil, or I could use canola oil. So I'm going to try it that way and see how it turns out. Bring you guys along for the ride. Almost thawed. That needs a few more minutes in the... I'd say like maybe 3 more minutes because there's a few pieces that are still... but this is my... Well, let me do it this way. That is my homemade cream of mushroom soup that we made not last week, maybe the week before. I had it in the freezer. My daughter wants some to put over top of sure that it's not. Let me taste it. I might have to add a little bit of milk to it because it's kind of thick. That is so good. You know it's good when you're licking the spoon. I'm going to add just a touch of milk to it. About a half a cup of milk. And then this is going to go back in the microwave. I'm going to put it in for it. Clean back in the microwave for about 10, or, wow, 3 minutes. And then that should be enough time. You want your potatoes to be golden brown all the way around, so. But I think because I added a little bit of extra flour, that might not do that. It might not turn brown. What I should have done was I should have done what I did in the first place, was just add a cup and a half of flour, my three eggs, mix it all together with the Parmesan, or not Parmesan cheese, wow. I added Parmesan cheese to it to give it a little bit more flavor, but also to help bind it, and parsley. So, let me check my... Oh, yeah. Nothing like homemade. Cream of chicken and cream of mushroom soup. Just can't beat it. Oh, I need hot water. I gotta put cheese on top of these. Sure that they're done all the way inside. Cut into it. Make sure it's done. And if it's done, it is not. Okay, so it's got to go back in. For part to get done, for the meat to get done. The potato part of it is done. So, and then the last few minutes, you're gonna sprinkle some cheese on it, and dinner's done. I don't want to keep you guys too long. I appreciate you coming back in. You were able to see what we were able to do, and I'm glad I stuck it out. So, I'll take a picture of it when it's done, and post that as my thumbnail so you guys can see. I appreciate y'all's time. I appreciate y'all sticking it out with me. And like I said, I left it in, you know, the mistakes that I made. And next time I'm going to stick with just the recipe and not do any more, and put it in the refrigerator and let it, or freezer, and let it cool for about 20 minutes to a half an hour. Then oil my hands, put it around the meat, pop it in the oven. So thank you all for sticking around. I appreciate it. Later.